Would you probably want to create something cool like this cinematic animation in Blender? Let's consider the main points of how to create a cinematic and how to make it look like a real movie, not just a CGI render in this short Blender tutorial. First of all, let's take a look at the final animation which I already created for this video. Let's start with the environment. I have a model pack for this animation. Here is grass, my pumpkin blender models. You can download this model pack from my Patreon. House and scarecrow that I've got on Sketchfab. First, I will draw grass using the Secret Paint add-on for Blender. This free add-on that allows us to draw any object on any surface in the Blender scene. But the more useful feature of this add-on is the opportunity to make wind animation for this grass. I already told you on my channel, by the way, subscribe if you're not subscribed yet, that to achieve photorealism we need high quality models, textures, and that's true, but for animation we also need to follow the physical effects of our world. Elementary, it's wind. But since my scene has a moving camera, I can even ignore the fact that I need super quality textures. And if I do render of one static frame, we can see that on the ground not enough details for quality displacement, and in the dynamic we will not notice that. But absolutely static grass will definitely spoil the impression of realism. And I bet you may not even notice that, but our brain works in that way that we easily perceive what we already used to seeing, but immediately become aware that something is wrong when we see something not typical or not real. So, as I always say, realism in the details. The simple wind animation gives us a sense of reality to this environment. I would say we even can ignore the quality of texture and models if the situation permits it, but to achieve realistic video animation, better not ignore simple wind effects, so that your animation doesn't look like just a static image and the camera moves through the static world, as well as the movements of the camera. It's worth to pay more attention to the camera settings, you know? So, in this scene, my goal was to make the camera movements like the first personal camera, like in some horror movie or game. And we could just animate the camera with keyframes, but it would look exactly like the static motion I talked about before. So, to give realistic camera movements in this case, I used the noise effects for each axis of movements of the camera in this scene. This already gives an absolutely different result if we compare the camera just animated by keyframes with the last one. This is also about those physical effects that we have to simulate to achieve realistic results and cinematic. For more details about how to make such cinematic animation with all details, I posted a full tutorial on my Patreon. I recommend you to watch this tutorial, link in the description. Also, you can download the scene and all the material from this video tutorial. And another important effect for the camera that will greatly improve the perception of your animation is motion blur. Very often many people ignore this, but it's exactly the effect that will give cinematic movements to the camera. In short, at the moment of moving camera, this appears blur effect between frames. We can see, for example, this effect here. The more movements of the camera, the more this effect will be expressed, but we can also control it in the settings of Blender. What's remarkable is that in the one separate frame, like here, we see a lot of blur effect, but it's only one frame, and in the video animation we don't see a lot of blur because we already seen 24 or 30 frames per second depending on which FPS you use. But you can't ignore this fact because it gives smooth movements and creates a cinematic look, which we also love. Alright, realistic materials, textures, models, cool camera animation, all this is very important and definitely will make your animation a cool frame from the new movie. But here's what will really turn your animation into cinematic animation, its color grading and post effects. We usually use DaVinci Resolve for that, but we also can do everything in Blender, you know? Usually I start with post effects like glare. This will add an amazing glow to the image, then color grading. I want to add contrast using curves, and we can grade our picture using color grading. Considering that this scenario is closer to some horror scenario, it would be great to use the color scheme related to such plots. I have a video on my Patreon about color grading in Blender that you can see. We will talk about how can make different color grading in Blender using compositing. So here what is bring a very cool cinematic effect to our picture is the film grain, but not usual grain, you know, such grain with scratches as an imitation of old film. I very love to use such grain in my artworks, just like lens distortion and vignette, which can be added in Blender as well as chromatic aberration. Now this picture looks like a cinematic animation, and you already can share it with your friends, but wait. There is another and the last very important point. Sound design. It's big mistake to ignore sound design. Usually people make cool animation in Blender and just upload them under some music from Instagram. Come on. Here's an example of the same animation where I just added music. Do you agree this doesn't look as cool as this one? Feel this difference. In this case, the addition of ambient sounds, footsteps and heavy breathing behind the scene add atmosphere and emphasize what is happening inside scene. It also immerses the viewer and creates that very cinematic look. And more precisely, the combination of all these moments that I showed in this video turns a simple camera animation in Blender into cinematic animation. It makes the process a little more complicated than just making a scene and animating the camera, but the result is worth it, yes? So you can watch the full tutorial on this animation with all details on my Patreon. There are also another interesting videos about Blender, and you can download my Blender assets and materials from this video tutorial and other video tutorials. So thank you for watching this video, special thank you to my Patreon supporters, and see you guys in the next video.